What is up, everyone? Circle Flex here. Be you guys in another replay. Today, we're going to take a look at the Oni. And this should be uploaded right around the time-ish within the week, where they're testing HE changes. So I figure it would be kind of funny to show one that has an HE derp. Because the Japanese heavies, I really don't like them. So you might be wondering, but Circle, why are you playing them? Well, you know, I'm on a crusade to flea mark all the tanks that I haven't yet that are in the tech tree. So, and this is one of them, unfortunately, so I'm playing them. And the regular gun is just really bad and should need a buff. And the derp guns are just the way to go, unfortunately. So yeah, derp guns it is. And what a derp gun do we have? Oh, 149.1mm explosive HE. 75 pen, 890 damage, and a pretty decent-ish reload. I think it was like 16 seconds or something like that. Something along those lines. I don't know why the replay never shows the reloads, but yeah. So armor-wise, Oni is decent. You know, if you have enough pen, that lower plate is really easy, you know, to hit. And the things on top here are obvious weak spots. And what's mostly annoys me about this tank is not only the derp gun, but actually the fact that the gun has good gun depression, but obviously not over these. So if you're aiming the gun frontal, right, you can have all your gun depression. To the sides you do as well, but not so much over those two. So it makes it really awkward to shoot this thing at times. In cities you're not going to notice it as much, but still it is pretty damn annoying. Because otherwise it has fairly decent gun depression, right? So armor is like, eh. The armor is like, it's one of those things that Wargaming does really horribly, is that the armor is too good against minus 2 and too bad against plus 2 or even plus 1. Heavy tanks are in like a really awkward state there. The same goes for like Black Princes and whatnot. Like the armor on the Black Prince is perfectly fine against tier 6s, but against the tier 8 or even some tier 7s, you're kind of like, yeah, okay, I guess I die. So yeah, this T29, basically we're butchering him. We put about 3 shots into him, 948 damage. It is what it is, and we're on Ghost Town, which is kind of lucky because it's a fairly small map and there's just a city in the middle, and it's really obvious that you just go there when you're playing a heavy, right? So, trying to support here, Stock Tiger 2, only a critical hit, no damage, we hit the gun, nothing happened. RIP. And yeah, we have the Stock T29 with us here, and an IS as well. The IS, I think he was just yelling at the T29 for some reason, but hey. So yeah, Ghost Town, Oni, tier 7. Matchmaking spread is pretty good. No artillery. This is the way I like it. No artillery and like plus 1. That's perfectly fine by me. And yeah, we're just basically gonna brawl in the city and try and use the derp gun to the best of our capabilities. The zero line is looking a bit iffy, and I'm just like, maybe I should help the T25-2. You know, you don't want to be sniping real vehicles with HE at all, ever. But we're gonna have to try if you want to help our teammates out, right? So I'm just looking here, seeing if I can get away with anything. I know I'm really poorly angled here, but you know, if someone creeps up in front of us, then we'll have the armor situated, basically. And I don't think this wheel vehicle will be inclined to shoot us, but we do get spotted, so the wheel vehicle's probably buzzing around somewhere. We do have good free range. All of the Japanese heavies have good free range, probably because they're so big or something, I don't know. I think the base free range is like 390 or something on this already. So our free range is nice, but hey, the camouflage will still beat us every time, right? And they're probably in some kind of bush somewhere. So that's basically what we're doing. Firing off a blind shot, because I'm just like, hey, I'll fire one blind and then move on with my life. But I think we might peek back and forth a little bit, and now we're going to check in front of us. The 1357 doesn't want to live on this planet anymore and just YOLOs at 12T whilst getting shot by literally everyone. And then the Stock Tiger 2 kills one of ours, and the AMX actually gets away with it. But on a lot lower health, of course. So yeah. So here I'm thinking, like, how did I get spotted? Maybe I got spotted here in the front or something like that. I'm basically kind of waiting on the Tiger 2 as well. And yeah. So like, dude, these Japanese heavies, man. For me, they're so boring and they don't add literally anything. I feel like this is like the safe space for really bad players or something, because they're ridiculously easy to use. Shots like that are just dumb. Like, and granted, he's stuck, and with a regular gun, I probably could have overmatched it, but still, like, there was nothing there that was just like, oh man, so much skill. Like, I've been in the same square of the map. We're not fast. We're fighting in the city, doing our thing. But I really feel like these kinds of tanks are just so anti-fun for like almost everybody involved. I think they're super boring. I don't think they have a really high skill ceiling at all. Like if you can, if you have somebody in front of you, it doesn't matter if they're side scraping or not. You just kind of go blap, and it's like, okay, good day. Nice aim for the weak spots, by the way. Lol. Like, and this is what I mean. Like, I'd rather see these things neutered to have a regular gun. And maybe some, and you definitely need to buff the regular gun as well, because the regular gun is pretty damn terrible. So terrible, in fact, that they had to add premium shells to that gun at some patch, at some point in time as well. So, just to give you the indication. So now we actually got shot by the scout, by the little scout behind us, because the T25-2, you know, died to them. And now the AMX is far behind me. KV-3, and he already shot us, so we have time to aim. I guess we'll hit him for 345, who knows, we could have killed him, we couldn't, maybe we couldn't have, who knows, it's derp guns, who knows, no one cares, right? So he has to carefully aim at weak spots with his AP shell with 175 pen. I can just kind of derp him in the face and don't give a fuck, right? We also have like 60 million health, because we're super heavy at tier 7 for some reason, which I'm also very against. Ah, guess we'll derp the T-44. Who cares? Hit him in the tracks. Who cares? We still kill him 244. Probably would have been 400 alpha. Who knows? We don't know, because they cheat. Extremely random. Who cares, right? So yeah, we shoot him. Wait for the reload again. I'm going to see if I can kill this KV-3. There's some wrecks in the way, but I don't want to expose myself too much. So KV-3 shoots. He messes it up. There's an EBR behind me. That's bad news. And me thinking I can turn around quick enough, but nope. So now the KV-3 gets another shot, which is bad, but we're just gonna go like, oh, there he is, okay. Oh, so much skill, so much aiming, much wow, oh my god. So the E-25 actually comes to my rescue here, because that EBR could be annoying. As you can see as well, I'm backing off into a building so that the EBR cannot circle strafe me, just to make, you know, extra sure here. So, wheeled vehicle comes to us, I tried to block him off, I don't get it, and now we have to turn the hull. We have to turn the turret as fast as we can, and incoming, the biggest bullshit shot of the universe, boom! We hit close to the wheels, I guess, or the ground even, and killed the wheeled vehicle. Much skill, such wow. Alright, so we're a really big vehicle, so we can look over some of this rubble as well. And guess what, there's an enemy Gojira over there as well, the Oni, but I have the high ground, Anakin. Alright, listen, this is gonna be easy. We bait the shot, he only does 199. I actually go and shoot underneath him to try and do tracking and more damage. We do 3 criticals and 362, leaving him on 51 health. We could have also killed him, but hey, who cares? It's HE, it does whatever the fuck it wants, apparently. So now we're just gonna reload. Obviously, the Oni is pretty badly hurt. Chances are he might be Amaranth or something like that. I take the perfect spot here. He hits the rubble, we shoot him in the face. He dies for 51. GG, right? So now it's 4 against 4. We've already racked up 2600 damage literally by just derping people and not really thinking about our shots all that much, because we're finding other heavies, so there's not much weak spots we can shoot and pen with an HE shot like this, right? So this is why I think that especially lower tier HE just needs the buzz off, man. Like like, what is this play experience? I just run around, derp some people, snipe some people, it's fine, I guess. Like, just give all the heavy tanks just non-derp guns, man. At the very least. Like, this entire line is so dumb. So incredibly dumb, it just hurts. And now we have an AC and a Scorpion, both of which I can probably HE pen. The Scorpion will need to hit the turret, I think, and the AC will probably need to hit, like, a side shot. So I'm just gonna go in there and help the team out, because our right metal seems to be falling asleep at the keyboard from camping the same spot for the last 5 hours. So Scorpion comes in, boom, actually managed to pen him. Pretty lucky shot, we hit him above the tracks there, but we don't do enough damage, and he's shooting the APCR. There's no way we're gonna bounce this, and we're just gonna charge in hoping for a bounce of sorts. But yeah, that's the Scorpion, and we're about to die. So Scorpion gets us with the second APCR shot. He actually low rolls the first one, but it doesn't matter. Both shots would have been more than enough to kill me with average pens. But it does leave him on so little health that the E-25 can just roll in and kill that guy. So now the grand total is 3,400 damage and 73, bouncing 1,400. And yeah, that's about all she wrote, right? So now the E-25s can move up. The charioteer is the last guy alive. They can even cap if they wanted to. And here we take a look at the E25. Charioteer comes in. That's actually a pretty big mistake. Like, the that E25 100% knew the health of the charioteer. All you have to do is wait on the second E25 to secure the kill, right? He kills one of you, the other guy kills him easy. Now we're going to be reliant on some awkward exchange between the E25 and the charioteer, both of which can be one shot for each other. And there's a Rheinmetall that falls asleep at the keyboard over there, who might get a snipe in as well. And there you have it. He gets sniped by the Rheinmetall all the way from here, getting him 4 kills. So yeah, Oni, utterly boring. I don't know why these derp guns are in the game, and I don't know why they're super heavies at the lower tiers. I think the only super heavy in the game should have been the German ones at tier 9 and 10. I also think the VKP at tier 8 is a bad idea. And yeah, these guns, man, I don't know. I feel like the skill involved in playing these is so incredibly low that my nephew, that is now 5, can probably have a similar game if he knows the basics, right? And I guess that's kind of the targeted audience, but I feel like it ruins the player experience for more people than it actually gains, right? I feel like this infects so many more people for every one person that enjoys it that I think we should just do a hard pass on these and remove the derp guns at the very least, because they're not going to take away the tanks, right? So yeah, anyway, this was an ace. We did 19 criticals. So yeah, very skilled, of course, because by God, we were really trying our best to snipe and hit weak spots there. We're top damage because, well, we were very skilled and the HE shells are hard to use. And we did 1500 base XP, racked up a bunch of medals, including the ace, and we even made 34,000 credits with a non-premium because we didn't use any of the consumables. So yeah, is that a GG? Not really, right? Like, we just went to Ghost Town, farted around one square of the map, charged the Scorpion, and that was about it. And I think that's, like, the peak gameplay that this thing provides, because if you're on an open map, they're super fucking boring. If you're on a city map, they tend to be pretty boring as well. If you get overmatched by even one tier, you're pretty screwed as well. And you're, yeah. I just think it's a super negative play experience to have super heavies in the game at lower tiers. And I think it's a super negative play experience to have these derp guns in the game, because, like, they're the most skillless, soulless pieces of machinery in this entire game, if you ask me. But I would like to hear your thoughts on this. Leave your thoughts in the comments down below. I'll see you guys in the next video. Thanks a lot for tuning in. Peace out, guys.